Hello and happy Friday for everybody. It's September 30th, 2022. Let's see what time it is. It's about 1:15 in the afternoon. And it's cold. Now there's some general aviation traffic going in and out of Chester County today. There's some people shooting some landings. There goes a small Piper, fixed gear. It's always interesting and fun to watch the small airplanes use the same airport as, you know, the as the Learjets, as the Citations. And the bigger private jets, you know, private jets waiting for like maybe three little piston poppers to land so they can get off the ground. But it's a nice advantage to have if you're using a private jet to get around, to have an airport like this is close to Philly and completely unregulated. So completely uncontrolled. There can be advantages to that. I understand it. It's colder than what I'd expect to be this time of year. So it seems like if I'm complaining about the weather one way or the other, a couple weeks ago it was like over 85 or 90 degrees, and I was complaining about that. I'm not complaining about this cool weather though. This doesn't bother me. The hot weather bothers me. I wanted to let my audience know, for any of those that might be interested, I'm researching the flat spin phenomena, and I think there's a lot of misunderstanding and bad information about that. It's really a difficult thing to understand if you think about it. Flat spin, you know, the airplane is like, let's say this is an airplane flying straight, except for my little finger, that's never straight, but I'll be using a model airplane in the near future too. I've got like a ton of them. They're all packed away though. An airplane goes, so for any kind of spin, from what I understand, requires the airplane to stall and yaw. The flat spin, such as the one that I've called out the Baron 58C on, is unrecoverable, which is not acceptable. If I am in charge of the FAA, I would tell the manufacturers of the large prop piston twins and the turbo twins to the turbo props, I'd say you got to come up with something. And right away, I know that they could fix that problem. It would cost a little money, but I don't think it would be that expensive. My idea, okay, you go into a flat spin like those two poor guys, the two poor souls that crashed in Sacramento County earlier in September. I've mentioned them several times. It's just unacceptable, you know, just to like report what happened in the accident and then move on like everything's normal and okay. Things were not normal and things are not okay. Those two guys were a real asset to their community, to their profession. The flight examiner that was killed, Richard Conti, man. And again, I always reference Juan Brown at Blanco Lirio, but he talked about those guys. They get paid for the work that they do. They don't get like a salary or anything. They're private contractors, those FAA examiners. So they don't really work for the FAA, is what I'm saying. And but he had so much time and experience, and so did the guy that he was checking out on the twin, Kevin Mueller, I think his name is, the CEO of a grocery chain in California. But they, you know, when I looked at that chart, and I hope some of you did, and you see what the risk is when you have to do, in a check ride, you have to do an engine out scenario, and you take that left engine out of that Baron, and you're at around 104 and 105 knots, you are knocking on heaven's door, to say the least. And there was another Baron accident earlier this year that I have to find out about, but I saw it briefly online. I think it was a guy and his son his young son were killed in a Baron 58 city. They lost an engine, not on takeoff though. And so there's some eerie similarities there between those two accidents. And what I think happens is once that Baron gets into this region where the stall speed overlaps the minimum control speed, you are in trouble in that particular area. If you're under 105 knots, you're in trouble. You're in a bad, excuse me, in a bad, dangerous situation. But the flat spin, how does it keep spinning if it's flat? A flat spin. So I think when people are talking about a flat spin, the airplane is still in a queer, unusual, abnormal looking a configuration. I think that its nose is still down, and I saw a video that indicated this recently on another really bad twin engine crash, where once you lose control and you go into that flat spin, I don't care if you got like 5 miles of altitude, you're not going to recover. But I think the recovery should be designed into the airplane with, you know, try some things that are outside the box. For example, these little jets that spaceships use to, you know, change their attitude or maneuver somehow or another. Nitrogen they use, compressed nitrogen. Well, if a powerful twin, if a high-performance twin goes into a flat spin and there's nothing else that will recover it from that spin, why not try that? Try little jet nozzles that could, you know, reposition the airplane and then push it forward and try to recover from the stall. The first thing I get, what do you think the first thing I get when I suggest that fix? Oh, that'll never work. That'll never work. Well, get out of here. I want to go back to the couch and watch some more football and drink some more beer. Don't bother me with that crap. The skeptics, you know. They're needed too. Skeptics are needed too. You think that's a good idea? Well, let's try it. I think you're wrong, but let's give it a try. Anything's better. Anything. Come up with something. The result of those two guys, I mean, there's some disturbing accidents in general aviation. I'm just beginning to scratch the surface about it. There was a father-son. God, where was that? That was brutal. I think it might have been in California, too. The son was a 24-year-old new pilot. He just signed on with Spirit Airlines. And his father had been flying for a long time. They owned this single-engine plane, and they crashed on takeoff, and both of them were killed. Okay. This is a bad problem, and it's crying out to be fixed, but nobody's doing anything. So, all right, well, here comes a Cessna on final. It looks like he's, like, overshooting the runway, and he's trying to pull it in tight. Boy, be careful. When you're going base to final, man, I tell you, he's coming right over the top of us, too. He's flattened out there. That steep turn on base to final, man, that's something you better be on your game with. Anyway, I'll let you guys go. I've got some specialty programs coming up soon. I just wanted you to know about it. And I hope you're all doing well. And I hope we're going to have a great October. I hope. Today is AI Day for Tesla, by the way. And I'm a big Tesla fanboy. And that's something that's going on today. Not that it matters to you. Anyway, you guys take care and have a great day and a great weekend. The Dolphins took it on the chin last night. I was actually betting on the Bengals. I bet on the Bengals because I was thinking, well, Tua could beat those guys. And I think Tua is in a better sweet spot or a sweet zone in his game than Joe Burrow. I think Joe Burrow gets stronger and the Bengals will get stronger as the year goes on. Boy, the Bengals got some players, man, both on defense and offense. That guy Burrows, whew. What a monster he is. And he's a monster that can run. They're the worst kind. Anyway, you guys do well. Stay safe. And any feedback you can give me on flat spins, man, I would really appreciate it. Take care.